This is Papa from Street Fighter TrainingSystem.com. All right, this is Thursday.
We are the 27, and here we go for the Papa review of the day. Okay, so once again, haven't traded live, haven't looked at any trade happening live, but I want to show you a little bit what would have been my mindset while looking at the market. So I just want to say that it is okay. If you haven't found any trade, so I had a hard time to actually find anything. I found only one trade based on the course one that was okay to take. Okay, so just a reminder on the legend of the trade. So if it's white, it's that you can take it if you are only 7-0 out of the day, because they are aggressive, crazy, and basically you are trying to get more luck into your day. Yellow triangle, you don't take it, and you will see that actually the chart only have yellow triangle. And then red rectangle, it's a trade that I would have taken based on the course. Okay, so let's deep dive on it. So number one thing, if you look at the day, right, so it starts flushing down a lot. Right, so the first mistake that you should never ever do, right, is to try to call bottoms, right? So even if you have divergence or whatsoever, don't fight the trend. Like you don't want to take short when it's late, but you also you don't want to take like reversal trades when it's flushing like this in a almost a 90 degree angle. Right, so let me show you a little bit. If I zoom, I'm gonna zoom a little bit on the start of the day. Right, so the day starts at 8:30. So again, all right. So first trade, actually, we have like an impulse to the downside. Show you trade. So this I mark it as white. So for sure you shouldn't have entered at the green bar, right? The reason is that the green bar is bullish, right? It's not touching EMA and whatsoever. But the reason why I put it white and I put like kind of an arrow over here is that it does a bullish bearish candlestick pattern, right? So this is not a bad pattern to take. If you really wanted to take the trade. But again, if it's at the beginning of the day, you have zero trades in, don't take this shit, right? But if you are 7-0 on the day and you have so much money and you are getting lucky, then it's a good trade to take, not on the green, but on the red candle. And I will place like a limit order just on the close of this candle. Okay. Next trade. So I saw that some people were asking me a question about divergence. So don't try to take divergence, as I say, if you see like it's flashing down like this, right? So the idea is try to not call bottoms, right? This is the number one mistake that beginners do, and you will lose money more than you will win in your life if you try to do this. But in any case, if you see divergence like this when it's straight and then the divergence is up, so straight and up, it's not what we want. We want something that goes down and up, okay? And the candlestick pattern is also fucked up, so just don't take it. What we want is to have like divergence, good candlestick setup. And I saw quickly that on Discord somebody asked me, what do I look at? I actually look at level 2. But it's a little bit too complex to be able to explain this. Okay, so anyway, don't take divergence. Don't take a look at it first. Master the two-legged pullback. Show you and show you punish, and then you will see how to take other trades. Anyway, so we continue. I didn't really see any two-legged pullback. I don't even know why I pointed this one. Is it? Yeah, because it's a two-legged pullback. No, maybe not. But don't take it. I think it's people that would have tried to call bottoms again. don't try to call bottoms, even though you see like a 1-2 kind of reversal candlestick pattern. Here, show you trade, candlestick, kind of okay. I think candlestick kind of okay, but I don't know. Actually it's not on this candle, but it's on the next one that you entered, and the candle is not okay anymore, right? So actually I pointed to the right one, the wrong one. So it's up, down, up. It respects the property, but here you see that there is a short-term trend line opposing that is not good at all, right? So you don't want to take this trade, and the candlestick is not good, so you cannot take this trade. Here, I wanted to talk about this one. Actually, I could have put it as green, as white. I can argue that it's green. So we could argue that it's actually white. So when you 7-0 on the day, but so here we have show you punish, right? And we have the price that is above the 50 SMA when we take the trade. But one thing that I don't like is when I see this pattern with a candle that rejects the 50, right? I'm often afraid to take this trade as good trade. Okay, so yeah, only take this type of stuff if you are like willing to play your luck. But so far we don't had any trade, so we are zero on the day. Okay, finally there is a trade that follows the course number one, and even though it's not super super good, right? So we have the SMA that angles a little bit up, and then we have a first retrace. So if you see this, we have up, retrace over here, right? So it's this candle, not this one. So this could have been taken, and here I point that if you take your risk to reward ratio, you would have filled your target, right? So again, for the course at part number one, you need a 2 reward, 2 for 1 risk, and you can allow yourself to have like only, I would say, 50% win rate. Okay, anyway, just after this trade, for those who are looking for Shoryu, there was a very bad Shoryu. So 2 candles that are going up, candlestick not good, so definitely you should not take this. Then we continue the day, so short term trend line, we have a show you over here, so no opposing, but the problem is that on the leg we have several candles going down, right? And on the show you trade, the logic is that you cannot have more than 1 candle, and second, also this candlestick pattern is not very good. Okay, it happened that if you looked at the 2000 tick chart, this was the best trade of the day because it did like a Pikachu golden. So yeah, for people looking at the 2000, they would have got this trade and enter in and got all the down move. But in the 1000 tick, definitely you cannot take this show you trade. Okay, again, so maybe some people would have tried to go into this divergence, but it's the exact same as what I was talking about earlier. If I have like a straight line is going up, straight and up is not divergence for me. And also the candlestick pattern is not good. I don't trade live, so I cannot look at the level 2, but yeah, this is one thing that I would have looked at. What else? So we continue on the day here. Would I want to take like a show you punish? So the answer is no, and again, the reason is that you would have need to enter right with the 50 SMA acting as resistance, and you never want to play to show you punish when your candlestick is in between the 50 and the 21. Okay? Continue, the price is going up, there is no much opportunity. Here it does show you trade. You cannot take this shit. Honestly, like you can see that you're super late to the party, and then most probably this thing is acting as, you know, so the short term trend line is acting as resistance, right? So the opposing STT. So you cannot take this, and this candle also is the candle of evil. So I call it the doji, and yeah, don't, if you ever see this, don't take any trade. Okay, so I think that's pretty much what I saw. Ah yeah, maybe another trade that I would have taken, but not based on any course. And again, I don't know, looking at the day, I think that I would have given up at 10 p.m. Because honestly, there was zero setup that was worth it, right? But on this one, just to explain it a little bit, so we have a two-legged pullback move, and as I say, when we have this, like a flush down, right, it's probably because, I don't know, something happened, which is not normal. And then what we are looking at is to have like a double bottom, and we want like the Fibonacci to be shy of the 50. That means it doesn't touch the 50, have like an equal bottom, and here we have a two-legged pullback, so it's a good sign that it's gonna go like a little bit higher, right? But honestly, again, probably wouldn't have taken that. Yeah, I think I stopped looking at 11 because the day was horrible. So yeah, this is pretty much what I saw during this day. So basically, zero trade. There was one which was here, but following the part one course for those playing Shoryu and Shoryu Punish, zero. Okay, nada. So today you don't have any money. So if you follow people from internet telling you $500 a day, keep the doctor away, unfortunately you will have to go to the doctor today. All right, see you next time. Bye.